Hey, Tabby. What's up? You don't really know me, and I don't really know you, so, you know, just tell me if I'm overstepping my boundaries with this, but there's just some weird things going on with you. And I just wanted to ask, what the fuck? When scientists go looking for new planets outside of the solar system, one of the ways they do it is by watching for changes in the brightness of stars. If a star dips in brightness, it could be because some kind of object is passing by it. If it happens consistently, as in a star dims a certain amount at a certain time and on a regular schedule, you can bet there's probably a few planets or asteroids orbiting it. And so far, this has been a simple and reliable way of finding objects circling other stars. A lot of exoplanets have been discovered in this way. Then scientists found one star that looked like a promising candidate for exoplanets. And let's just say, in the layman's tongue, got really weird really fast. Welcome to the last episode of Aliens Month. I'm Vibby, and on this episode of A Space Alien Explains, Tabby's star. So about 1600 light years away in the constellation Cygnus, there's a star.
It didn't take long for you to run out of ideas for the script, did it?
Shut up, Pask. A group of citizen scientists from the Planet Hunters Project noticed a star that was exhibiting odd dips in light. As I mentioned earlier, regular dips in brightness signal that some kind of object is orbiting around the star. But this star was different. The changes in brightness were unpredictable and irregular. It was nothing they'd ever seen before, and they just couldn't figure out what was happening. I believe the scientific term for this kind of situation is called what the f***. The star known as caught the attention of astronomer Tabitha Boyajian, who announced the discovery of the star in 2016. And ever since then, they've been monitoring the star's activity, trying to find an explanation for its behavior. And then they nicknamed it Tabby Star. Thank f***ing God, because look at its actual name. Look at it. Who thought this was okay? So there's a few ideas why Tabby Star is acting like the stellar equivalent of your crazy uncle with a meth problem, but they're all educated guesses at best. The most likely culprit is a cloud of dust surrounding the star, which makes a lot of sense if you think about it. But we're not here for sense! We're here for the weird s***! For a long while, astronomers thought the reason for the strange flickering is because some alien species was harvesting the star's energy using a Dyson sphere. Yep, a Dyson sphere. The same exact one we were talking about in this video. If you didn't watch that episode, all you need to know is that Dyson spheres are a hypothetical megastructure designed to absorb the maximum amount of solar energy coming off of a star. That said, Dyson spheres can only be constructed by extremely technologically advanced civilizations. I just find it really funny they jumped to aliens as the logical explanation before they came up with dust cloud. Remember, if you can't figure something out the first time, blame it on the aliens. And normally, this is where the story would kind of end. They're still keeping an eye on the star, since they're not 100% on the dust cloud theory for some reason. But surprise! They found another one of these weird-ass motherfuckers. A team working with the Vista telescope in Chile found a star that was dimming irregularly, just like Tabby's star. They decide to name it VVVWIT-07, which in science smart people code means what the f***? I'm joking. The code actually means, what is this? Actually, it's not that much different from my idea. They haven't come up with a definite explanation for the irregular brightness of this star either. There's just not enough data to say for sure yet. So do Tabby and what is this have aliens? We can't say definitively, but it's certainly an exciting possibility to look out for. And that concludes Aliens Month. It was fun while it lasted, but next week we'll be getting right back into the usual historical weirdness. Full disclosure, the next episode's on cannibalism. Yum. Hi everyone! Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this episode. This week's featured fan art is by BoringYT on Twitter. Link to the artist's page is in the description. And here's some comments from the last video. If you enjoyed this episode, please be sure to drop a like and hit that subscribe button. If you're interested in supporting the channel, I have art commissions and a Ko-fi page available. Buy me a coffee and I'll make you a little sketch as a thank you. Links to that, as well as links to my social media, are in the description. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you real soon.